I love my group, and for all the reasons that we talked about with like the multidisciplinary focus, for all of the strengths and weaknesses that I bring to a team based on my personality and my skill set, I think my team was just amazing. I had a fantastic team, and these are people that I still talk to, that I still keep in touch with. And it was an amazing experience just to really understand the concepts that were taught in seminar and during our coursework, and then being able to apply it sometimes literally minutes later.
One of the things that I have taken from my CPRL experience and brought into my professional work is that there's no problem in the world that can't be solved better than with multiple minds.
It was awesome. Like, I loved working with people from the other graduate schools. I think it was a really great reminder that you don't necessarily have all the answers, and that other people's vantage points or experiences or graduate degrees that they have give them expertise that you might not have, and it's okay to go ask a lawyer about questions related to law, or go ask a public policy person about questions related to public policy. And currently at the Boys and Girls Club, we have folks who have all sorts of different backgrounds, and we all realize that without every one of us together, we wouldn't be able to serve our community the way we want to.
So when I came into CPRL, I came from a science background. I'm a chemist by training, and most recently I studied education policy. But in order to really do this project well, we had to think of it from different lenses and different perspectives. So through CPRL, I was able to sort of learn to think about a project from a legal perspective, because there are a lot of legal issues everywhere, as well as from a business perspective. And it definitely helped having teammates who had expertise in both of these areas. So it definitely forced me to just attack a project from multiple different ways, and sort of realize that there's no one solution to a project. There are many ways we could tackle a project, and they're all absolutely valid, but definitely the solution is much stronger when there are different perspectives involved.
So we had all these different expertises, which was amazing. And then it was really easy to divide work for that reason, because we all had our own biases. Hey, that sounds interesting to me. That sounds interesting to me. So we were able to divide and conquer. What was challenging was then taking all of that research or all the work that we did in our individual silos and bringing them back together. So making sure that when you're bringing back that work together, that you're not just bringing it back and say, here, it's done, but you're going so far as to also teach the other members of the group exactly what you learned from it, so that it can slowly start to fuse together toward one cohesive end result.
One of the projects I worked on was based outside of the United States. And so when we were interviewing stakeholders, a lot of those folks did not speak English or spoke English as a second language. Luckily, we had a woman on our team who was going to the public policy school and who spoke that language. And so she was able to conduct a lot of those interviews for us. And then we used like different translation systems so that everyone else could see the interviews or read the interviews and actually like understand what was going on.
So we engaged people starting from teachers. Stakeholder group you would think is so important in, you know, discussions around education, but people hardly bring them to the table. To ESCs and LEAs, to be able to talk to a bunch of executives and senior commissioners who were in a position of being able to impact change. The most valuable way I think we were able to engage was meet them where they worked and be able to really come up with what could the theory of change for these people in their current state look like and what would be where they should be. So just being able to understand the difference and meet them where they were, to take them to a state of idealness where they need to be, was where I think we were able to engage stakeholders, meet and develop because of the framework we were provided.
Graduate schools talk a lot about being able to apply your knowledge to the professional sector that you want to pursue. CPRL actually helps you bridge that gap. They talk you through those different, you know, policy areas, education areas, law focus arenas, And you also then get to dip your toe into it and kind of try it on with the guidance of the amazing CPRL staff. And then you also get to collaborate across different schools. So through osmosis and through just the collaborative spirit, you're able to really pick up on so much. And I feel like I left that with a lot of close friends, a lot of great new insights, a lot of great professional connections along the way, an amazing resume builder. And I just also learned a lot. I find that I'm referencing what I learned during that semester way more than anything else I learned during graduate school.